Now let us go through what is oxidation disk. So oxidation disk means is nothing but it is a long continuous channel, and the length of the channel varies from 150 meter to around 1000 meter. And normally this oxidation disk, it is oval in plan, and it is a one form of an extended separation system. And here it is an endless disk. And here that oxidation, that disk itself can be used as an aeration tank by providing a rotor. So once the influent entering into this oxidation disk, the rotor rotates, and what happens is that it aerates the sewage well. So sufficient amount of oxygen can be supplied by rotating this rotor. So that there is an aeration mechanism used within the oxidation disk. And here in case of oxidation disk, we are not giving any primary treatment. That is, we are not providing any primary settling tank for this oxidation disk process. And here this is the figure. So the influent will be entering into this oxidation disk, where we are providing a rotor, and the rotor will be rotating with a velocity of 0.3 to 0.4 meter per second. And after this, when we rotate, what happens is that it aerates the sewage well. And in case of this oxidation disk, if you are using an intermittent system, there is no need of providing a separate settling tank. But in case of continuous flow type of oxidation disk, there we can provide a separate settling tank. So here in this figure, you can see a settling tank also. So after this aerating the sewage, that sewage is sent to the settling tank. That is for the settling of the sludge, and a part of the sludge can be returned to this oxidation disk containing this aerating mechanism, and the excess sludge we can dispose into the surroundings, or it can be sent to this large digestion tank, and the effluent is taken from the settling tank also. And the channel, this open channel, it is an earthen channel with the sides are sloped, and the floor is also lined by using concrete or brick, and with the vertical walls. So raw sewage we can directly pass through the oxidation disk by passing this raw sewage through the bar screens, because the sewage may consist of larger particles, floating objects, etc., in order to prevent the entry of those objects into this oxidation disk, we can use a bar screen. And then we are aerating the sewage within the oxidation disk by using this rotor, which is placed across the channel, and we are imparting a velocity of 0.3 to 0.4 meter per second, so that that velocity we have to maintain within that oxidation disk. That is to prevent the settling out of the biological sludge. And normally a cage type aeration we are providing. So the die of the cage type rotor, it is around 70 cm and the speed is 75 rpm. So the oxygen transfer capacity within this oxidation disk, if you are considering per hour per meter 2 kg of oxygen, we have to provide within this oxidation disk at 16 cm depth of this immersion. So that is the oxygen transfer capacity that is taking place within the oxidation disk. And the rotor imparts a decay circulation, that is for 120 to 150 meter cube of ditch volume, if you are considering per meter length of this rotor. And this oxidation disk, the depth is around 1 to 1.2 meter, and the length we have to provide should be in a ratio. That is, the length, whatever length we are providing, it should give sufficient aeration tank volume also. So if, depending upon the sewage that is coming to this oxidation disk, we can provide the length of this tank. So normally the oxidation disk, the length varies from 150 meter to 1000 meter. And the width of the disk, if it is divided by this rotor length, it should give a ratio between 1.5 to 2.8. So the width of the disk and the rotor length should be in a proportion. That is, if you are taking the ratio, it should be between 1.5 to 2.8. And the longer the ratio, mainly used for the shorter length of 0.9 meter to 1.2 meter. And the return sludge and the raw sewage, they can be discharged into the disk, that is, especially at the upstream side of the rotors, and through the outlet of the disk. This outlet of the disk normally is located just opposite to the inlet. So oxidation disk means is nothing but it is a long continuous channel, and the length of the channel varies from 150 meter to around 1000 meter. And normally this oxidation disk, it is oval in plan, and it is a one form of an extended separation system, and here it is an endless ditch, and here that oxidation, that ditch itself acts, can be used as an aeration tank by providing a rotor. So once the influent entering into this oxidation ditch, the rotor rotates, and what happens is that, so here in this figure you can see intermittent flow type and continuous flow type. In the intermittent flow type, there is no need of providing a separate settling tank, because in the intermittent flow type, what we are using is that the inlet will be closing, and inside the oxidation ditch, the sewage will be there. We are aerating the sewage by using the rotor mechanism. After a particular period, the rotor gets stopped, then allowing the sludge to settle at the bottom, and the sludge is taken from the bottom of this oxidation ditch, and the effluent is taken out. So that is the intermittent flow, whereas in the continuous flow, what we are using is that here in this figure itself, you can see there is a clarifier, that is a separate settling tank we are using. So here in the continuous flow, the flow is continuous, and here we can return this a part of the sludge to the this oxidation ditch also. So the difference is that in intermittent operation, intermittent, the flow is not continuous, whereas in continuous flow, the flow is continuous. 24 hours we can continuously make the sewage flow into the oxidation ditch. In the first type, that is intermittent flow type, there is no clarifier, whereas in continuous flow type, we are using a clarifier. So in the intermittent flow type, number of settling tanks can be used, but here the flow in the ditch, we can remain suspended, that is during a predetermined period, that is by stopping this rotor. And the ditch itself, therefore, you can be used as a settling tank, because we are stopping this rotor. So the sludge will be deposited at the bottom of the tank. So there is no need of providing separate settling tank. And the effluent can be withdrawn from the outlet, and the excess sludge can be removed from the ditch using the sludge trap. In the continuous flow type, the operation is continuous. That is by allowing the mixed liquid to settle in a separate settling tank. So the sludge will be settled at the bottom of this clarifier, which can be removed by using the airlift pump, and can be returned to the ditch also. And here the ditch is operated as a closed system in case of this continuous flow type. And due to the this volatile suspended solids, we have to periodically remove the sludge from the oxidation ditch. So removal of the sludge, it is done from the mixed liquor or from the sludge sump, which is from the bottom of the ditch. And normally this intermittent operation can be used in the smaller plants. In case of continuous operation, the oxidation ditch normally is followed by a secondary settling unit, as in case of the extended aeration system, that is already explained in the previous videos. And the design criteria of this oxidation ditch, the length varies from 150 meter to 1000 meter, width varies from 1 to 5 meter, depth varies from 1 to 1.5 meter, detention period, it varies from, normally we provide 12 hours to 15 hours, and the concentration of suspended solids in mixed liquor, normally that value always we try to keep it as 4000 milligram per liter within the oxidation ditch, that is for obtaining a BOD loading of 45 meter cube per kg. Now coming to the advantages of this oxidation ditch, because here we are not providing any primary settling tank, so we can, the method is simplified, and we can remove more than 95% of suspended solids, and we can remove more than 98% of BOD also. And the disadvantage is that more power is consumed in rotating the rotors.